Are joined, Hari?
Yes, yes.
So what happened? In our last class, we faced one issue, right?
Yes.
For that, we have done kernel upgrade, right?
Yes.
After that, we have go further further next steps, right? So now, here it has been stuck. Okay, start Java engine. Okay, still yesterday onwards, it is stuck here only. Okay, the SAP INST has been stuck here. Okay, Muzaid Rajesh Bala. Yesterday we have seen this page, right? Start Java engine. Correct? So, still it is showing the same phase, okay, is running. Okay, what we will do is, we will restart the SAP INST, okay, file, exit. This is our MMC. Save console settings. No. Really want to exit? Yes. Thank you. Okay, SAP INST has been cancelled. Got it? See here, any SAP INST service is running or not. Okay, after that, in C, in task manager, not this. In task manager, is there any SAP INST service is running or not? SAP INST is not running. Okay. So now we will try to start the SAP INST again. Where is your INST? Installation master, Windows x86-64. And these are SAP INST, right? Run as administrator. Which service we have selected? Netio 7.0, SAP, SAP Systems, MS SQL Server, Central System. Correct? This is we have selected, right? Previously? Go to the next. Now it is asking, see, run a new option, continue with old option. We need a continue with old option. Why? What is the reason?
Already we have installed in the middle. Already
So, if we, yes?
Here we, if we have selected run as the new option, so the, again, what about the previous information? It will be canceled.
Okay. If you click on run with the new option, okay, you will not able to see the old one. Old installation was hanged. Already installed, right? So yes. The old installation will not work. Again, you need to give a run with the new option. Means it's a fresh installation, no. Right? It's a, it will start, it will ask you again. Okay, so we already started the installation and we already completed our FAF stack installation, right? So now here we need to go with the old installation only. Okay, don't go with the run with the new installation. Why? Because we already 75% phases are completed. Now only Java stack only we have a pending, right? So if you are in inputs phase, if you are in a defining parameters phase here, second phase, if you are in a defined parameter phase, then you can go with the run with the new option. Okay, but we are in already execute services phase here, right? Define parameters is completed, check parameters completed. Now we are in execute service phase. So now we need to continue with the old option. So in our last phase, how many phases are completed? Okay, it will cross check from the log file, SAP INSC log file. Okay, that's why it is going so fast. Are you observing?
Yes.
So these phases are already completed in our last phase.
Yes, we were stuck at about 33 phases.
So up to 33, it will go fast because the phases already completed and the phases log files already there in our operating system level, right? It will cross check again. It will cross check and it will go to the where we have struck. It will go to that step. Okay, so we are in 35 phase. Start Java engine. So now in the down C, start instance DVE VM JS00 starting. So SAP INSC is trying to start my instance DVE VM JS00. What is a DVE VM JS?
Dialog update into background message gateway spool.
Yes. What is 00?
Instance.
That is my instance number. And how many phases are left? These phases are left. See, in the top, install Java engine. So my Java engine has been installed. Okay, configure UME, user management engine. Okay, we will discuss about this next class. And start Java engine. My SAP INSC is trying to start my Java engine. See here. ABAP stack is starting. Java is unknown. Okay, ABAP stack is in starting phase. It is not yet started. It is in starting phase. Let's wait to start ABAP stack and Java stack.
What type of cases we need to stop the installation and redo again, Mr. Ramu?
If it is hang. So see, we are in this phase only, yesterday onwards, right?
Yeah.
So after that, I have checked this, it was hanged, okay. So in that case, if it is SAP INSC has been hanged, then we can restart our SAP INSC. Then we can restart our SAP INSC. So in Windows, you will face in real time some of the issues with SAP INSC. what are the real-time issues? Okay, one, SAP INSP will be hanged. Okay, in that case, what we need to do? We need to stop the SAP INSP process. How? Go to file and exit, right? This is what we have done, right? And go to processes and end process, right? Check in task manager if any SAP INSP process is running or not. And in Windows, what will happen is, if you are trying to SAP INSP to start, okay, sometimes it will not start in real-time scenarios. Then what we need to do? We need to take OS reboot. We need to take a OS reboot. Then what will happen if you take a OS reboot? If any SAP INSP process is there at OS level, all processes will be killed and you can start the new SAP INSP session. Okay. Once you are in execution phase, you need to select run with the old option. Okay. If you are in define parameters phase, then you can go with the new option. Okay, got it?
Yeah. Yes.
So now here, see, my ABAP stack in active phase, right? Active phase in the sense my ABAP stack has been started. And Java, what about Java stack? In Java stack, Java dispatcher is starting, not yet started. Once Java dispatcher has started, after that my server process will start. Okay, so both are in starting phase only. So this is my Java stack architecture. Muzaid, yesterday you said you don't know about the Java stack architecture, right?
Yes.
So this is my Java stack architecture. In Java stack, what I will have? I can have my Java message server, Java NQ server. This S means server process. Okay. And Java dispatcher and SDM. Okay. SDM, Java dispatcher, server process. Where my SDM is resides, that is my central instance. Okay. Java message server and MQ server, this is my central services instance. Okay, if I want to add one more dialog instance, then I can add one more dialog instance. If you add dialog instance, what services will be there? Java dispatcher and server process. Okay, why Java stack is required? Java stack will be handled by web browser request, correct? Web browser request. Well, so those web browser requests, who will receive first? Java dispatcher will receive the first, right? And Java dispatcher will assign the user request to my server process only. Ultimately, your user request will be executed by my server process. Each and every Java stack will have one default server process. that is nothing but server 0. Okay, this is server 0. Server 0 is nothing but my server process. Okay, this is server 0. If you want to add, you can add one more server process. Okay, and one server process, how can it will handle n number of user requests? N number of user requests. Why? Because when I install my Java stack, I will get only one default Java server process. Correct? If I have a one default Java server process, then how my n user request, how can it handle one server process? Because in server process, how it will work in the sense, the server process will work in the multi-threading concept in Java level. Okay, if you are talking a Java stack, the server process will handle n number of user requests, and each and every user request will handle by parallelly, okay, with the concept of, with the mechanism of multi-threading concept. So in one server process, it can handle n number of user requests at a time. That is called multi-threading concept, multi-threading mechanism. Each server process will have some memory parameters. Okay, okay. What is the memory parameters? We will see after our installation. And if it is increased, if it is crossed, okay, if it is already crossed my memory parameters in server process, then I can add one more server process, or I can add one more dialog instance. Okay, if you add one more dialog instance, then one more server process will become as a default. Am I correct? One more server process will come. Okay, you can add server processes, right? So that's why he has given, okay, dot 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 and one server process. Here also dot 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 one server process, because you can add if you require one more server process. Okay, and what is my Java message server will do? Java message server will do, will have a communication between the distributed Java dispatchers. Between the distributed Java dispatchers. Okay, what is my Java NQ server? The same concept of my ABAP stack. What my Java NQ server will do? My Java NQ server will do a lock mechanism concept. Okay, what are the objects are uses are accessing by user request? Okay, those objects will be locked by that user ID. Okay, for only modification purpose only, not for read access. Okay, for that purpose my Java NQ server will use. And what is my SDM? Software Deployment Manager. What is the use of SDM? It is used to upgrade my Java components, right? If I want to upgrade my Java stack components, then I require one tool, right? Using the tool, I can upgrade my Java stack components. So SAP has provided one tool, that is SDM, Software Deployment Manager. If you remember, in our installation, it asked me the SDM password also. If you remember, in installation, it asked me my SDM password, right?
Okay.
So I have provided my SDM password. So SDM is a software deployment manager tool. It is used to upgrade your Java stack components. Okay. Yes.
We have downloaded the install SAP ANSC through SDM, right? Or what directly?
Sorry, come again.
We have downloaded the SAP software. Is it through SDM or directly from AWS?
No, we have not downloaded separately SDM, right? So this will come with our Java stack software. We are installing a dual stack, right? We are installing dual stack, right? So in Java stack, the SDM tool will come automatically. So that's why it asked me the SDM password at the time of installation. Have you remembered that? in our last session, if you go to the last session, record session, it will ask you the SDM password also. Okay, just once cross check again. Why SDM is, when we connect to the SDM, it will ask you the password. Okay, then SDM tool will open. Through SDM tool, we can download, first of all, we need to download the Java stack components from Service Marketplace. Those components we can upgrade through my SDM tool only. That is the use of SDM tool. Okay.
And the central services instance will be there in only Java stack?
No. This is only standalone Java stack architecture only. Standalone Java stack. If you are talking about standalone, means single Java stack system, we have a Java message server and MQ server. Okay, we'll see the dual stack architecture.
Okay.
This is my dual stack architecture, ABAP plus Java architecture. If you are talking about ABAP, what are the services I have? ABAP message server, gateway server, dispatcher, and D dot 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 E. Means what is this last line?
DBE.
D dot 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 E means what? Yes, all the types of work processors, these are, right? And I have a ICM also. And if you're talking about Java, what are the services will be there? SDM will be there, Java dispatcher will be there, and server process will be there. So my SDM is there, and gateway service is there, NQ service is there. This is my central instance of my dual stack. Okay, this is my central system, not central system, central instance. This is my central instance of my dual stack system. Got it? This is my central instance of my dual stack system. Got that point?
Yeah.
Okay, just wait, we'll discuss about the JCO. And come to central services. What are the central services are there? Here I have a Java message server and Java NQ server. This is my central services. Okay. If you want, add one more dialog instance for my dual stack system. If you want to add one more dialog instance for my dual stack system, then this is my dialog instance. In dialog instance, what are the services are there? Gateway service, ICM service, ABAP dispatcher, and different types of work processes. Okay, here I don't have NQ service, right?
Yeah.
Where is my NQ service? NQ service will be there in central instance only, correct? And here Java dispatcher will be there, server process will be there. And here SDM will not be there. Why? My SDM will be there in central instance only, correct? So
yeah,
this is my dialog instance. Now, this is my ABAP stack and this is my Java stack, right? And this is my ABAP stack and this is my Java stack. How my ABAP stack and Java stack can communicate internally? It should be communicate, right?
Yes,
it should be communicate. That's why I have installed a dual stack system. If there is no communication, then what is the use of a dual stack installation, right? If it is and there is no communication, okay, if they are working standalone, then what is the use of dual stack? There is no use of installation of dual stack installation. I can go for a standalone ABAP stack installation or standalone Java stack installation, right? So it should be communicate between ABAP stack and Java stack. How it will communicate? Using JCO RFCs. JCO means Java connector, okay, through Java connector RFCs. ABAP stack and Java stack can communicate each other. Okay, here also in dialog instance also we have a JCO connections. In SAP terminology we call it as a JCO connections. Got it?
Yes.
Practically we will see how we can create a JCO RFC connections. Okay, how ABAP stack and Java stack can communicate. Okay, got it? Dual stack.
Yeah. Can you go to Java stack architecture screenshot.
Yeah. Starting apps. Java standalone Java stack, right?
Yeah. Okay. Here web browser request is received by Java dispatcher. There it is received by ICM.
Why? Because see, if you installed a standalone Java stack, for example, okay, if you install standalone Java stack, if you want to connect to the standalone Java stack, you cannot connect to standalone Java stack through SAP GUI. Do you get my point? Through SAP GUI, we cannot connect to Java stack.
Okay.
How we can connect? Through web browser only we can connect, right?
Okay.
If it is a standalone ABAP stack or if it is a dual stack, then we can connect to my SAP server through SAP GUI. Got my point?
Yeah.
Clear, right?
Yeah, so I think normally the companies will have both stacks. They will not be using standalone, I think.
No, in nowadays, after NetWeaver 7.4 onwards, SAP has divided ABAP stack and Java stack separately. In new versions, in new NetWeaver versions, we are getting standalone ABAP stack and standalone Java stack. So you can go for as a standalone ABAP stack, or you can install, you can go for standalone Java stack. Okay, so now SAP in, so actually why SAP has divided? See, up to old versions, up to NetWeaver 7.2, 7.3, we have a dual stack installations. So now new versions, why SAP has divided separately? Dual stack is separate, means standalone ABAP stack is separate and Java stack is separate. Because SAP intention is they are trying to remove entire Java stack architecture in the coming future. They are trying to remove entire Java stack architecture. Okay, and what are the features are available in Java stack architecture? Those features will be available in ABAP stack also. So that is the main intention. That's why they have divided ABAP stack and Java stack in our new versions, NetWeaver versions.
So in the new version, one after the another, we have to install. First, we need to install ABAP stack and then.
Yes. Depends on your requirement. If you required only ABAP stack, you can install only ABAP stack.
Yeah. Do we have installation of that covered, Mr. Ramu?
So that's why what I am planning is now that we are installing NetWeaver 7.0, right? This is the old version.
Yeah.
And what is our database? SQL. And what is our operating system? Windows. Okay, so that's why next installation I am planning for new versions. Okay, I will have a new version. We will write a new version here.
Yes.
So new version with Oracle database with Linux server.
Yeah.
Okay, so we will cover dual stack and single standalone stack also. Okay, either we will see ABAP stack installation or we will see Java stack installation.
So the course will be with the new version?
No, once we installed our dual stack, okay,
yeah.
Once our SAP server is ready, okay, then our topics, our what are the activities we need to perform as a basis consultant? We will continue on this. Why? Because here we have both systems, right?
Yeah.
ABAP plus Java. So in ABAP stack, what we can do? In Java stack, what we can do? Both we will cover in this SAP server.
So the screens will be same as it is in the new versions also.
new versions also same SAP INST tool only we will use, okay? But in old versions, to use SAP INST, SAP INST is available in installation master software, okay? If you're talking about a new version, my SAP INST will be available in SWPM software. SWPM means Software Provisioning Manager. Got it? This installation we will see maximum at the last classes. Okay?
No, no, what I am asking, the screens, like GUI screens for
administration. Same SAP INST screens, same inputs, okay? If you are talking about a Java stack installation, it will ask you only Java stack related inputs only. If you are talking about the ABAP stack installation, then it will ask you about ABAP stack installation inputs only. Same SAP INST, same screen, same, everything is same. Just inputs will be different and the software will be different. Software, anyway, software is different, right?
Okay.
Now it is in configuring Adobe Document Services space.
Currently we are using 7.5, I think, in the company.
Yes. Latest version 7.5.
What my doubt was, if you learn 7.0 course contents, I am talking about like so the same course will be applicable for 7.5 also. The work, I am talking the work.
Same concepts you need to work.
Okay.
I will tell you briefly.
Okay, Ram. Noted.
This is my ABAP stack. This is my Java stack. In Java stack, if you are talking a new installation, okay? In Java stack, what activities we will do? We need a client administration, security. Security means all role administration, user administration, authorization and all, everything. Okay, SAP security I'm talking. Client administration, RFCs, HTMS, right? Logon pads, profiles, background jobs, school configurations, memory management, daily health check, if you are talking about ABAP stack. Okay? If you are talking about Java stack, Java architecture, Java architecture, and what are the tools I can use for what? To administrate my Java stack, right?
Okay.
And how can I upgrade Java components to SDM, here also on is the stack upgrade. Kernel upgrade we have seen, right?
Yes.
And that's not. And how can I monitor my Java stack? How can I troubleshoot my Java stack? If we are talking about only standalone ABAP stack installation, new standalone ABAP stack installation for the new versions, we need to do all this one time. If you are talking about only standalone Java stack new version installation, we need to perform all this in separate. Right? So here we need to follow two times installation. And we need to discuss ABAP in one time, Java in one time. Now we have a dual stack installation, so we will cover all at a time. All at a time means one by one, not parallelly. Got it?
Yeah.
Course content or activities is same, okay? But some of the new features are be there compared to my Java old versions and new versions. Some of the new features are there. We will discuss what are the new features are there compared to ABAP, sorry, compared to Java old installation and new installation. What are the new features? Got it?
Yes, sir.
Installation methodology is same. Just we need to understand what are the new features are there. That's it. Any doubts, any questions till now? Bala? I didn't listen Bala's voice here. Every time he will ping only. What is stack upgrade? Good question. Are you able to speak, Bala? Means, do you have a mic, headphones? That's why I'm asking. Just raise one question if it is possible. Okay? Because in chatting, sometimes I will miss out. I will not see sometimes the chatting. If anyone see any chatting questions, okay? Please inform me. Okay. So what is a stack upgrade? It's a good question actually. So my ABAP stack has been installed successfully. Once your ABAP stack has been installed, ABAP stack related components will be installed. We will see what are the ABAP stack components will be installed. The components name, and every component will have a version, and every component will have some patch level. Okay, got it? Okay, default some components with some version with some patch level will come with my installation software. Got it? With my installation software. So after installation, one of your first step is, what is my first step? You need to upgrade your stack. Stack in the sense, what are the all components are installed. Okay, all components need to upgrade at a time. All components, the combination of components is nothing but a stack. What my point? Bala? Okay. All components, the combination of all the components, we call it as a stack. And as a post step, you need to upgrade your stack to latest patch level. This is one of the post step. Okay, and after your installation, you will have some kernel installed. Each kernel will have a kernel version and some patch level. Got it? So one of your post step is upgrade your kernel. Upgrade your kernel to the latest level, latest patch level. These two are the mandatory post steps. Once you installed a fresh system, then what you will need, what you need to do, one of the post step is, first of all, you need to upgrade your kernel and you need to upgrade your stack level. Okay, these two activities we can perform at a time, not separately, because when I am downloading my stack to latest level, okay, so it will include my latest kernel also. I can select latest kernel also. Got my point? It will include the latest kernel also. So at a time, I can do upgrade to stack, to my stack and kernel also. Through which tool we can perform this? Through some tool, software update manager. Through some tool we can perform stack upgrade. Parallelly, kernel also will be upgrade. Kernel also will be upgrade. Got my point? So in the same concept, if you are talking about a Java stack, in ABAP we call it as a stack. In Java we call it as a Java components. In ABAP we are calling the components. The components will be installed. Each component will have some naming convention, some version, some patch level. So same concept in Java. So we have some components naming convention. Each component will have some version level, and each component version will have some patch levels. Okay. So if you installed a standalone Java stack, Default the Java components will install with some version and some patch level. Okay, so as a first step, what you need to do, you need to upgrade your Java components to the latest level through SDM tool. Okay, or if it is the latest version, we can do through some tool. If it is the old version, we can use SDM tool. If it is a new version, we can use some tool to update my Java stack components. Got my point, Bala? Got it. Okay, great. So now all phases are completed, right? Seeing execution of service has been completed successfully. Now what is the pop-up message? Execution of NetWare 7.0 SR3 SAP system, MS SQL server, central system has been completed successfully. Okay, click on OK. So SAP INST will be closed. Okay, so SAP MMC, open SAP MMC. What is the use of SAP MMC? First question, what is MMC? What is the abbreviation of MMC? Any answer? What is MMC abbreviation? Anyone?
Management console.
SAP Management Console. right? And what is the use of SAP MMC?
To administer the services. Actual dialogue.
Start and stop SAP.
So we can do start, stop, and all the things. Okay.
Here one is the dialogue instance, right?
Which one?
NWMS one.
No, this is central services instance. Message yeah. Server and NK server. We are not installed a dialogue instance.
Yeah,
okay. Yes, we have installed one system. Do we have SAP GUI? You will see SAP GUI software. Do we have a SAP GUI software? I think we have. This SAP GUI also we can download it from Service Marketplace. No, this is empty. I think here we go. New data one is all export. Export new. So what is my SID?
DEV,
right? So what is my OS level user will be created? OS level users. DEV ADM. Right? DEV ADM is my OS user, right? It has been created at the time of installation. It asked me the password also, DEV ADM. Right?
Yes, yes.
SAP Service SID. This is also one of the user, right? So now, we have connected with my administrator user, right? So now we'll disconnect with administrator user. We will connect with my SAP administrator user. What is my SAP administrator user? SID ADM. SID ADM. And don't forget this username, sir. What is your SAP administrator user at OS level? Means SID ADM and SAP Service SID. If it is a Windows operating system, you need to remember this too. Got it? Now we will connect with that user ID. We will disconnect this.
You can
user is only for SAP, right? It is not AD user.
AD means
Active Directory.
No, there is no Active Directories.
Okay.
What is my user ID? SID ADM, right? What is my SID? DEV, right? So DEV ADM. What is my password? What password I have given? Master password.
India.
What is my master password, yeah?
Yeah, yeah. In India 123 something it was.
I am trying with a different. Yes, got it. Basis at the rate 123 B capital letter. Okay. So at the time of installation, you need to note down what are the passwords you are giving. Okay, the master password you need to note down in your installation screenshots, in your document. This is mandatory. This is a best practice. Tomorrow also we have a class, Sunday, same time, okay? Or we will connect some late. Is it okay, everybody? Not 6 o'clock. Everyone is available on Sunday? Bala.
What time, Mr. Ramu?
You suggest me, because you are in 3:30.
Yeah.
And then, right, everyone is free. You yes, suggest me, no problem. 6 your time?
Yeah, 6:30 will be okay.
6:30 means what is our time?
Your time
6:30. My time is 6:30.
Or 6:30 7 is also okay. 7 a.m. is also okay.
I am okay for any time. 7 is better, okay?
Okay.
Everyone okay? 7 a.m. IST.
Okay.
Tomorrow morning, 7 o'clock, not 6 o'clock, okay? Windows, about Microsoft Management Console. Management Console 3.0 version 6.1. Where is my installation path? E or F? Which one I have given?
E.
E. Because USR, SAP, SID, right? Sys. exe, uc, nt. Go to cmd. Okay. Now here type this plus what. Let's see what I'm getting. This plus work information. What is your kernel release? 720. What is your patch level? where is my patch level? This is patch number. Patch number is 300. This is one of the way to check your kernel release and kernel patch version at OS level. This plus work. Got it? Not only this location, we will try from another location. Wait. Close this. Okay, ESR SAP, SID, go to CMD, here type this plus work. Everyone able to see my screen? Kernel release 720. What is my patch number? 300. So the question is, how can you check your kernel release? How? At OS level, using with, what is that command?
This plus one.
This plus one. Right? At OS level, this is one of the command. Or if it is a Windows, how can I check? Go to kernel path. Right? Check the properties of this plus work file. Actually, we have seen this, right? For starting kernel upgrade. I will remember. Check the details. You have seen, right?
Yes, yes.
This EHC, UC, NT. This is my kernel path. Okay. Here, where is my displaced work? This is right click properties details. What is my version? 720. What is my patch level? 300. This is another way. Or in SAP level, how can I check? Log into SAP first, then there is a menu, system. In system menu, go to the status option. Then you will find out your kernel release with patch. Got it? Clear? System status. In system status only, we can find out a kernel and what are the components are installed. Okay, with my system. After installation, what are the components are installed and what are the components version names, okay, and what is the component patch level. This information also we can see in system status option, and also we can see what is my operating system details like host name, okay, what is my SID, what is my system time and the database details. All information we can check in system status option. Okay, this one, this one. system status option. Got it? So now we need SAP GUI installation. Folder, what is new folder? Desktop kernel. In SAP GUI data one log export kernel. Maybe here. What is this? Export. What is this? I think here. Yes. BL manager and another tab. I know this. Kernel Windows Linux JC policy SWPM. What is this? Okay, FWP.
So Ramusha, now we connect through browser also, right? We have installed dual stack.
Yes. Try that.
Ramu?
Yes?
Actually, from marketplace, which files we have downloaded for SAP installation?
For SAP installation, which version?
Which anyone is latest.
Which version you are asking?
Anyone is 7.4, 7.2. It will be better if you tell the latest version.
Sorry, your voice is breaking.
Actually, in which we have to export, import.
Export, import. What is
there are some import file you have to download at the time of installation.
No, I'm not getting your question.
Means in the fresh installation, we have to download the particular files in the sequence, like kernel, import files, that things.
Not import files, those are the export files. Export files, kernel files, okay, Java components, database client, JCE policies, is all we need to download.
Right, can you show that in the
NWMSS. Yeah, sure.
You see tomorrow. One single download?
You need to select all, okay, each one will have a separate softwares, you need to select all and you need to select into the add to download basket And once you added all the softwares into the added download basket, then you can download all at a time from your download manager. Got it? Add to download basket and after that you need to download from download manager, right?
Where to find that files?
Okay. Yeah, sure. Tomorrow we'll see.
Okay.
See, this is my NWMSS. What is this NWMSS? This is my host name. How can I check my host name? Go to prompt and click, and what is the command? Host name. This is my host name, NWMSS, right? So NWMSS, or you can provide IP address here instead of host name, colon 50,000. 50,000 is a standard default port number. And it means 50 and instance number 0, 5 instance number 00. Got it? 5 instance number 00. What is my instance number? 00, right? So 50,000 port is the default for my, what is here, SAP J2EE engine start page. It is a index.html page. If you click on system information, it is asking me the credentials. What is my Java Stack administrator user? J2E_admin, right? In the installation, go to the installation. It asks me the password for Java Stack administrator user, J2E_admin. I have given a master password, right? Note down what are the administrator users we are using. Note down at a notepad, okay? So this is my Java Stack engine details. Java Stack engine details. System DEV. What is DEV? This is my SID, right? This is my SID. See here, my SDM. SDM port, 5 instance number 18. 5 instance number 18 is my SDM port. DVBMGS00, this is my central instance. What is my operating system? Host, what is my host name? And software components. What are my software components? Click on all components. So these all are my software components names. See here, component name, SAP JEE, CAP, JLog View, SAP JEE Core. These are different components has been installed, okay, to my Java Stack. Got my point? Each and every component will have some version. What is the version? 7.00. This is my 7.00 version. And SP14 means support package level 14, means what is my patch level? This is my patch level. 14 is my patch level. Okay. If you go to the service marketplace, if you find out 7.00 in the latest level, if you find out SP14, SP16, SP15, 16, 17, anything, okay, then we need to upgrade it to the latest level. after our installation. Got my point? These are all my software components. These are component names. These are versions. 7.0 is my version. SP14 in the sense support package level 14. All these components. If I want to upgrade these components, I want to do using with SDM tool. Got it? These all are my components. NetWeaver administrator. See here. Read every service intention. What is the service use? What is the use of NetWeaver administrator? What is the use of system information? What is the use of user management? Okay, read that. Now we are in SAP NetWeaver administrator. Sorry, your browser is or program is not supported by Web10 Pro. Means our browser is not supporting. What is my browser version? Explorer 9. We can go for a upgrade of IE 10 or 11. Then our browser will support. Correct? SAP NetWeaver Administrator is a tool for administration and monitoring of your NetWeaver system landscape. Means using SAP NetWeaver Administrator, I can administrate, I can monitor my Java stack. Correct? We will see this tomorrow. NetWeaver Administrator. Tomorrow we will install SAP GUI and we will try to connect to our SAP system DEV. What is our SAP system? DEV. Through SAP GUI. And see what are the components has been installed and what are the versions, what are the patch levels. In Java level, just now we have seen what are the components, what is the version, what is the patch level installed. Okay, same in SAP GUI also. For ABAP stack, we will see through SAP GUI. Got it? Till now, any questions?